All right, we're live from the launch of the new Java motorcycles in India, and today Classic Legends has launched two all new motorcycles. The first one is the bike you see right here. This is the cheapest new Java you can buy in the country. This is called the Java 42.
There's a bit of connectivity issue, but
this bike is a very, very retro themed motorcycle that looks exactly like, or rather quite like, the older Javas that we've seen historically sold in India. As you can see, here's a reminder of Java's heritage.
42 is actually the more modern version. So we've got two models. Mm-hmm. That one's the more classic looking bike. It's called the original, it's just called the Java. It's not called anything beyond that. So it's just the Java. Mm-hmm. This is the Java 42. This one has slightly more modern touches.
Let's go to the details of the Java 42 first.
Offset. Gauge out here. Your headlight is separate from the fuel tank, unlike the original Java, which has a detailing just like the old one.
There's a switch gear. And you can see this very retro styled handlebar grip as well, which again is quite like the Javas of yore. Here's some badging. It says 42 here. A very neat little compact tail light on the 42. Let's actually start from the front here. Okay. This engine, as you see here, is a 293cc 4-stroke liquid-cooled DOHC engine. This is actually the first BS6 engine that is going on sale in India right now. This motor produces 27 brake horsepower and 28 Nm of torque. The gearbox is a 6-speed unit, and this engine is common to the 42 as well as this bike you see here, which looks closest to the original Java that we had on sale in India some decades ago. The engine is the same on both of these models, the 42 and the standard Java.
See the Java logo sort of thing.
Let's start with some other mechanical details of the bike now. What you see here is a 280 mm disc brake with ABS, a single channel ABS is standard on this motorcycle. The rear, however, is a 153 mm drum. So there is no disc brake at the rear, and obviously then no dual channel ABS either. But in proportions, in details, from what we can see as a first impression, there's great levels of fit and finish, good quality chrome, great paint surfaces. The tires, as you can see here, are from MRF. The rear tire is a 120-80-17, while the front is a 90-90-18. So it's an 18-inch front and a 17-inch rear. Here's a nice look at the standard Java. Shreyas, there is no update on a Road King right now, but that's a great question. Your expectation is the same as ours. We hope Java will go into its other significant models from the 60s and 70s as well. The build quality, from what we can see, is quite decent. There are no real ungainly welds. The finish of chrome, paints, pinstriping, and also there is also a good level of sort of tidiness on everything, the way it's put together. There aren't too many exposed cables. Here's a nice look. Sorry.
Some more just make it clear right away. It's got a gas charge conventional.
Right, so that's a look in the Java. As you can see, the key slot is
to the side of the fuel tank rather than on top of the headlight cowl. This right here is a toolbox, which is again similar in style to what you saw in the older Jawas.
Now this one is
the seat is also a well-finished unit. And overall, the bike looks very proportionate. It looks well styled, very appealing. Definitely will appeal to the audience that has been so besotted with Royal Enfields. So it will take away a share of the Royal Enfield audience. Prices for the 42, which is the motorcycle you see here, start at 1,55,000 ex showroom Delhi, which is this bike right here that you see in the foreground. This is the cheapest Jawa you can buy in India. The bike in the middle is the Jawa 40, is a classic Jawa that is priced at 1,64,000 ex showroom Delhi. And Jawa has a very special motorcycle here, which is of course the Perak. Now the Perak is actually a model that has a lot of history with Jawa. And this bobber style motorcycle you see here
will look like in the future. So the bobber is the
will go on sale later on in 2019. It's not gone on sale right now. However, Jawa has revealed the pricing, which is going to be about 1,89,000 rupees ex showroom Delhi. This motorcycle will be powered by a slightly more powerful version of the very same engine. It is going to be a 334cc motor as opposed to the 293cc motor on the other two Jawas there. This will also sport about 30 brake horsepower more,
this bike also has a price tag,
bringing its horsepower total to 30 bhp.
So we can see it,
and as you can see, this is a very, very unique, very distinctive motorcycle. We don't have a bobber in this price bracket. The nearest competition in terms of being a bobber is probably the Triumph bobber, which is at least 10 lakh rupees more expensive.
These bikes, do hit us a comment. Do drop your comments in.
There are some details, a closer look at the Perak headlight and the meters as well. Here's what it's called. It's the Perak, which is a fantastic name for a motorcycle, and it's got some great details, including this nicely tucked away monoshock. Development for this bike is not exactly ready yet, but it will go into production in 2019. That's what we have officially from Jawa. Here's what the three bikes look like together. We'll get you the engine sound in a bit. Right now we're indoors, we're not allowed to fire them up. A lot of questions about racing. Yes, there were a lot of questions to the Mahindra and the Classic Legends leadership today about racing. And while there isn't a concrete plan about racing at the moment, Jawa's racing history has been acknowledged today. And the other advantage is that Mahindra Racing, the team itself, has played a very, very crucial role in the development of this bike and also other two-wheelers within the Mahindra fold. So the possibility of Mahindra and of Jawa going racing is tremendous. The appeal is very strong, but at the moment, as of today, there isn't a concrete plan in place for Jawa to go racing. The seat height of these bikes is 765 millimeters. That is for the 42 and for the standard Jawa that you see here. 765 millimeters should make them very, very accessible to even short riders. Another thing that will really help is the 170 kg curb weight, and that despite the fuel tank being a 14 liter unit. So overall, these bikes are quite basic, quite simplistic in terms of what they offer. But at the same time, we get the feeling that these are quite well-built, well-finished products. Of course, the definitive verdict on this will only... We will reserve that for when we actually ride these motorcycles, which should also be very, very soon. Although that day isn't today, unfortunately. Right now, there is no comment from Jawa in terms of going into bigger displacement. But they have a lot to prove to begin with in terms of reliability, in terms of network, in terms of... also building a reputable network across the country. So if this 300cc platform is successful, then I'm sure Jawa will have the motivation to go into higher displacements as well. The engine sound, like I said, unfortunately, we cannot fire them up right now because we're an indoor facility, and therefore it's not something we can do right now. But of course, at the first opportunity we get to actually fire them up, we'll definitely do that for you. Here's a nice look at the twin exhausts, which are quite a design highlight. Historically, and even on these motorcycles as they are right now, it's a great detail. Which of these three do you like the most? Which of these three do you find most appealing? The lights aren't LEDs, and yeah, the seat height, as I mentioned, is 765 millimeters. With a curb weight of 170 kilos, which is quite a decent ballpark. It should be quite manageable in the city. It's also not a very large motorcycle in terms of dimensions. So yeah, it should be quite manageable. And it still has enough presence. It'll still be, I think it'll prove to be good company on the highway. But of course, this is an assumption, so you have to hold on to my final verdict on it once we actually ride the bikes. And yes, as of now, 105 dealerships have been appointed by Jawa, with 64 being fitted out as we speak. So deliveries will begin in early 2019. We hope that is January and not any later than that. Yes, both the bikes have a single disc brake, which is of course at the front with ABS, but the rear is a 153 millimeter drum. Here's the rear shock absorber. You can see the gas canister as well, with the exposed chain, semi-exposed chain. Overall, the bike looks quite mechanical. It's a beautiful, lots of beautiful details actually. Okay, I will repeat the prices one last time before we go off air. The first bike you see here to the left is the Jawa 42, which is priced at 1,55,000 ex-showroom Delhi. The second motorcycle you see here is simply called the Jawa, and this motorcycle and the 42 are mechanically absolutely identical. So the standard Jawa is priced at 1,64,000 ex-showroom Delhi, while the Perak, which is this factory custom bobber, which hasn't gone on sale right now, but will go on sale and go into production in 2019, is priced at 1,89,000 ex-showroom. So here's one last look at the Jawas. If we can get them fired up at a later stage today, we'll let you know. And all right, I have a request for somebody wanting to see the gear lever. So, well, here it is. All right, so that's it from the Jawa launch for the moment. We'll get back to you with more if we can spend some more time with them, probably fire them up as well, we'll get back to you.